Take a close look at NASA's latest out-of-this-world image from the James Webb Space Telescope, and you'll spot something of this world.
NASA has released the strangest image ever captured by the James Webb Space Telescope. The James Webb Space Telescope was launched 3 years ago, around 1.5 million kilometers away from Earth. This telescope orbits around the Sun looking for distant cosmic bodies, and now it has captured one of the latest images that looks strangely familiar. The scientists even nicknamed it the penguin and the egg. But seriously, what are we looking at here? Is it a star constellation? Is it a nebula or something else? We are going to find out in this video, the James Webb Telescope. Our curiosity and hunger for knowledge have pushed us to visit unimaginable parts of the universe. While we cannot go ourselves, we started creating telescopes that could. The James Webb Space Telescope is the most powerful and ambitious of them all. The JWST is more like a time machine, a cosmic detective, and a window into the universe's deepest secrets. But how did this incredible idea come to life? Let's rewind to the early 1990s. After the Hubble Space Telescope revolutionized our understanding of the cosmos, scientists began dreaming of a successor that could peer even deeper into space, beyond the limits of Hubble's vision. This vision led to the birth of the JWST project, with one primary goal: to observe the first galaxies that formed after the Big Bang. That's right. This telescope was designed to look back in time over 13.5 billion years. Building the James Webb Space Telescope was not a walk in the park. It took decades of planning, designing, and overcoming countless challenges. The project officially started in 1996, involving a collaboration between NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency. These organizations pooled their expertise, technology, and resources to bring this incredible telescope to life. The JWST's construction was as impressive as it could get. The telescope consists of several key parts, each crafted for its unique role in this cosmic mission. We need to learn about the different parts of this telescope to understand how it really works. So let's have a look. The most important part is the primary mirror. It is the star of the show. The primary mirror is a massive 6.5-meter-wide mirror made of 18 hexagonal segments, each coated in a thin layer of gold. This mirror is the largest ever launched into space, and it was designed to capture faint light from distant galaxies, stars, and planets. Its size and precision are what allow the JWST to see objects that are billions of light years away. Then the telescope has a sunshield. You can say that this part is a giant cosmic sunblock. The sunshield is a five-layered structure about the size of a tennis court, which was designed to protect the telescope from the sun's heat and light. Each layer is made of a special material called Captain, coated with aluminum and silicon to reflect the sun's rays. The sunshield keeps the telescope cool as it keeps its temperature around minus 233 degrees Celsius. This temperature level is important because it allows the telescope to observe faint infrared signals from the distant universe without interference. After that, the telescope has an integrated science instrument module. The ISIM houses the four main scientific instruments that do all the work. These include the near-infrared camera, the mid-infrared instrument, and spectrographs. Together, these instruments capture and analyze the light collected by the mirror, allowing scientists to study everything from the birth of stars to the atmospheres of exoplanets. There is also a spacecraft bus. This is the backbone of the JWST. It holds the telescope together and contains the systems that power and control the entire operation, including communication, propulsion, and data processing. You can say that this is the telescope's nervous system, which makes sure everything runs smoothly while it floats a million miles from Earth. Given that the whole structure is too complex, creating the JWST was not cheap. The total cost of the project soared to around $10 billion. This price tag covered everything from the initial designs and engineering to the launch and the ongoing operations. It is one of the most expensive scientific instruments ever created, but when you think about what it is capable of, it is worth every penny. With all these impressive features, you might wonder, how does it even work? How do all these parts come together to show us the universe that is present millions of kilometers away? The science behind it. The James Webb Space Telescope is a massive camera in space, but it does not capture pictures like our standard cameras do. Instead, it captures light from the furthest reaches of the universe, places that are billions of years away. But how does it actually do that? The telescope captures light, not in the way our eyes do, but through infrared wavelengths. Why infrared? Because the objects it is looking at, like distant galaxies and stars, are so far away that their light has stretched into the infrared spectrum. By collecting this light with its giant gold-coated mirror, the JWST can see things that are invisible to our eyes. This light is then sent through the telescope's scientific instruments, which process the data and create images. Now, when you see those stunning images from the James Webb Space Telescope, know this: they are not in color, at least not naturally. The light the telescope captures is often outside the visible spectrum, meaning our eyes cannot see it. The concept of wavelengths is important here, so listen carefully. Different colors correspond to different wavelengths of light. Red has a longer wavelength than blue, for example. The JWST's instruments capture light across a range of wavelengths, and scientists then assign colors to these wavelengths to create the images we see. But these images don't come out of the telescope ready for Instagram. They need enhancement. This process involves combining data from multiple exposures and cleaning up any noise that might have interfered with the image. It is a long, tiring job, requiring both human expertise and computer algorithms to make sure every detail is sharp, every color is accurate, and every star or galaxy is clearly defined. And in the end, we get jaw-dropping images that not only look beautiful, but are full of scientific information. Now, remember when we said that the James Webb Space Telescope would help us observe the Big Bang? What does this actually mean? How can it see into the past? The Big Bang happened about 13.8 billion years ago, and it was the very beginning of our universe. However, we are not looking at the explosion itself. What the JWST is observing are the earliest galaxies and stars that formed just a few hundred million years after the Big Bang. The science behind this is mind-blowing. Because light takes time to travel, when we observe distant galaxies, we are essentially looking back in time. The further away an object is, the older the light we are seeing. So when the JWST captures images of these ancient galaxies, it is capturing light that has been traveling for over 13 billion years. This gives us a glimpse into what the universe looked like shortly after it was born, a period we have never been able to study in such detail until now. This is incredible, isn't it? Now, do you want to see the very first images James Webb Telescope captured? The first images. The James Webb Space Telescope made history when it launched on December 25, 2021. After decades of planning and overcoming countless challenges, the world finally watched as this revolutionary telescope began its journey into space. But how did it get there? The JWST hitched a ride aboard an Ariane 5 rocket, which was provided by the European Space Agency. This rocket launched from the Guiana Space Center in French Guiana, situated on the northeastern coast of South America. It was a critical moment. There was no room for error. Fortunately, the launch went off without a hitch, sending the JWST on its way to a destination like no other. The telescope was not sent into orbit around Earth. It was headed for a special point in space known as the second Lagrange point, or L2. This point is located about 1.5 million kilometers, or nearly a million miles from Earth, in the opposite direction from the Sun. But why did we choose this point? You see, at L2, the gravitational forces of the Earth and the Sun balanced the JWST's orbital motion. This allowed it to stay in a stable position with minimal fuel consumption. This vantage point is perfect for a telescope like JWST, providing a clear, unobstructed view of the cosmos with minimal interference from Earth's atmosphere and heat. After its successful journey to L2, the James Webb Space Telescope had a series of crucial deployments to complete. Its massive sun shield needed to unfurl perfectly to protect the telescope's instruments from the sun's heat. The mirror also had to unfold and align with precision, an operation that was both nerve-wracking and awe-inspiring. Once everything was in place, the telescope was ready to start its mission. It was in July 2022 when NASA released the first stunning images captured by the JWST. The wait was over, and the results were nothing short of spectacular. Among the first images released was the now famous deep field view, showing an array of galaxies billions of light years away. This image, known as Webb's first deep field, offers the deepest and sharpest infrared image of the distant universe ever captured. We are talking about light that has traveled for over 13 billion years to reach us. Essentially, we are looking back in time seeing galaxies as they were just a few hundred million years after the Big Bang. Another image showed the Southern Ring Nebula, which is a cloud of gas and dust surrounding a dying star. This image captured the intricate details of this nebula, revealing the star's final stages in stunning clarity. The JWST also captured a breathtaking image of Stefan's Quintet, which is a group of five galaxies interacting with each other, located about 290 million light years away. These images are breathtaking, no doubt, but they are also rich in scientific data. These allow astronomers to study the formation of stars, the evolution of galaxies, and the composition of distant celestial objects in ways never before possible. What's incredible is the level of detail we are seeing. The JWST's ability to capture infrared light means it can see through clouds of dust and gas that would otherwise obscure our view. This is why we can now see parts of the universe that were previously hidden from us. But weren't there already a telescope out there? Why couldn't the Hubble telescope capture these stunning views? JWST versus Hubble. When it comes to space telescopes, the James Webb Space Telescope and the Hubble Space Telescope are the best of their time. But how do they compare? What makes the JWST better? First, let's talk about the differences in their design and technology. Hubble, launched in 1990, has been orbiting about 547 kilometers above Earth, capturing breathtaking images of the universe for over three decades. Hubble primarily observes in the visible and ultraviolet wavelengths, which means it sees much like we do, though it can also capture some infrared light. It has given us iconic images of the cosmos, from the pillars of creation to distant galaxies. On the other hand, the James Webb Space Telescope was designed to observe the universe in the infrared spectrum, which helps us study the distant past. And now you already know why it uses infrared for this. Yes, because the universe is expanding, the light from the earliest stars and galaxies has been stretched, shifting into the infrared range. JWST's massive 6.5-meter gold-coated mirror is specifically optimized for capturing this faint, stretched light. This allows it to peer through cosmic dust clouds, revealing structures and details that Hubble simply cannot see. Another big difference is where these telescopes are located. While Hubble orbits Earth, JWST orbits the Sun at a point known as the second Lagrange point, about 1.5 million kilometers away from our planet. This position keeps JWST's instruments cool, away from the heat and light of the Earth and Sun, which is important for its infrared observations. Hubble, on the other hand, has to deal with periodic sunlight and Earthshine, which limits its observing time and capabilities. You might be wondering, why didn't we just keep using Hubble? Why build the JWST at all? The answer lies in what we want to see. Hubble has been an extraordinary tool for observing the universe, but it has its limitations. Because it mostly observes visible and ultraviolet light, it cannot see the earliest galaxies that formed after the Big Bang. Those are in the infrared range. On top of that, Hubble's smaller mirror limits its ability to capture the faintest objects at extreme distances. To observe the early universe, we needed a new tool, one that could look further back in time and see in wavelengths Hubble couldn't. That's where JWST came in. While it has been capturing stunning images since the time it was launched, recently it has captured something so bizarre that has stunned scientists all over the world. What has the James Webb Space Telescope captured this time? The recent image. The latest image released by NASA is named the Penguin and the Egg, because it really looks like a penguin is playing with an egg in the photograph. So what are we seeing here? These two things, the penguin and the egg, are actually two different galaxies, interacting with each other. These are officially named ARP-142, released in July 2024 to mark the telescope's second anniversary. This image reveals a fascinating cosmic event that took place 326 million light years away in the Hydra constellation. The penguin is a spiral galaxy, NGC 2936, that has been distorted by its close interaction with a compact elliptical galaxy, NGC 2937, which forms the egg. Over the past 25 to 75 million years, these galaxies have been locked together due to their gravitational pull. They are slowly pulling and twisting each other. The penguin's once orderly spiral structure now resembles a bird, with its bright galactic center forming the eye, and its spiral arms creating the beak, head, and tail feathers. Meanwhile, the egg remains largely unchanged, reflecting its older and more stable nature. The image also captured a blue haze around the galaxies, which are made up of stars and gas drawn out by their interaction. This interaction has sparked bursts of new star formation within the Penguin, especially in its beak and tail regions, where the gas has been compressed. The egg, however, shows little new star formation, as it contains less gas and dust. These galaxies are gradually moving closer, and over the next few hundred million years, they are expected to merge into a single galaxy. The JWST has also captured other galaxies in the background. Among them is the young galaxy PGC 1237172, which is about 100 million light years away and located near the top right of the image. This is a fascinating discovery by the James Webb Space Telescope, but it is not its first nor its last. What other amazing things has this incredible telescope discovered? Other discoveries. Did you know JWST has successfully detected some of the earliest galaxies ever formed? These galaxies that were observed appeared over 13 billion years ago, just a few hundred million years after the Big Bang. Other than studying galaxies, the JWST has made incredible observations of exoplanets, which are the planets orbiting stars outside our solar system. The telescope's ability to analyze the atmospheres of these distant worlds has led to the discovery of water vapor, carbon dioxide, and other chemical signatures that suggest the potential for habitability. For example, the JWST observed the exoplanet WASP-96b, a gas giant, and detected clear evidence of water in its atmosphere. These findings bring us closer to identifying planets that might support life. Another fascinating achievement of the JWST is its ability to observe the formation of stars and planetary systems. By studying these regions, such as the iconic Carina Nebula, astronomers have gained insights into how stars and their accompanying planets form and evolve. The JWST has also provided new insights into the behavior of supermassive black holes. By observing the centers of distant galaxies, the telescope has detected the influence of these colossal objects on their surroundings. For example, it has captured evidence of powerful jets of energy being emitted by black holes, which regulate the growth of galaxies. Such evidence helps us understand the complex relationship between black holes and the galaxies they inhabit. Looking ahead, the future prospects of the James Webb Space Telescope are incredibly promising. One of the primary goals is to continue exploring the early universe, which means going into the cosmic past to study the first light emitted after the Big Bang. This research could reveal new information about dark matter, dark energy, and the fundamental forces that shape the universe. The JWST is also expected to make groundbreaking discoveries in the field of exoplanet research. Scientists want to study the atmospheres of a broader range of exoplanets, including Earth-sized rocky planets in the habitable zone of their stars. By doing this, the telescope may identify planets with conditions suitable for life. This telescope is also looking for biosignatures or evidence of life on an exoplanet. In other ways, it is on its hunt for aliens. Other than this, the JWST will continue to study the formation and evolution of stars, galaxies, and planetary systems. The James Webb Space Telescope has already changed how we used to look at our universe. Now its future discoveries promise to be equally transformative. If you want to watch more amusing content, go ahead and like this video and subscribe to the channel, because we have got a lot more of this. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.